It feels really good to be back here. I was a part of a session before, and I again thank Stephen Rudd, sir, for this opportunity.
Let me start, okay?
Okay.
So welcome, Shivani and Darshana. Happy to meet you. It is a Mind Your Mind program. Mind your own business. Mind your own words. These are the words we regularly hear. இதிலிருந்து கொஞ்சம் மாறுபட்டு நம்ம பேசணும், சிந்திக்கணும் அப்படின்ற ஒரு காரணத்துக்காக மைண்ட் யுவர் மைண்ட். யூ நீட் டு திங்க் இன்சைட் அவர் மைண்ட். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த எய்ம் ஆஃப் கோர் எய்ம் ஆஃப் திஸ் ப்ரோக்ராம். த பார்ட் ஆஃப் த ப்ரோக்ராம் வி ஆர் டிஸ்கஸிங் செவரல் திங்ஸ். இன் திஸ் டிஸ்கஷன் வி ஹேட் அ செஷன் அபவுட் வேர்ட்ஸ். Whether we are we talking? We are productive words. That was the session. It went well. But it has not completed. The continuation of the same session, we are doing this. We are going to discuss the reality. What is reality in communication? What's happening? How people are talking? And when they are talking, are they realizing their words or not? The real experience we have to share. This is the core thing of today's program. Solvalan, Sorvilan, Anjan, Avanai, Igalvila, Yarkum Arudu. Idu Kural. Solvalan, Sorvilan, Anjan, Avanai, Igalvila, Yarkum Arudu. Sollatral Padithanagum, Alla Solvalam Padithanagum, Palrupada. சோர்வு அறியாத உணாகும், சோர்வுன்றதே தெரியாது இருக்கும். அஞ்சா நெஞ்சம், அந்த ரெண்டும் இருந்து மனதில் தைரியம் நிறைய இருக்கும். இந்த தைரியம் இருந்ததுன்னா யாரும் அவங்கள வெல்ல முடியாது. இது திருவள்ளுவர் 2000 வருஷத்துக்கு முன்னாடி சொல்லியிருக்காரு. இதனுடைய பேஸ் நாம் எப்படி பேசுகிறோம், சொல் வளத்தோடு தான் பேசுகிறோமா, சிறப்பாக பேசுகிறோமா அப்படின்றத நமக்கு தெரியவில்லை. மற்றவங்க சொல்லும் போதும் நாம் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் பண்ணிக்கிறது இல்லை ரியலாகவே. நிறைய பேர், ஒரு சிலர் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் பண்ணிக்காங்க, பீப்புள் யூஸ் டு அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் அண்ட் தே சேஞ்ச். பட் லாட் ஆஃப் பீப்புள் தே டோன்ட் அண்டர்ஸ்டாண்ட் வாட் தேர் டூயிங், வாட் தேர் டாக்கிங். திஸ் இஸ் அ சிச்சுவேஷன். ஃபோனில் பேசும்போது பார்த்தீங்கன்னா நிறைய பேர் பேசிட்டே இருப்பாங்க. ஒரு ஃபோனை எடுத்தாங்கன்னா நாம் என்ன சொல்ல வரோன்றதை கேட்க மாட்டாங்க, அவங்க பாட்டு கண்டினியூஸாக பேசுவாங்க. தே டோன்ட் லிசன் வாட் ஃபார் தே பீப்புள் கால்ட் அந்த ஒரு திங்கிங்கே இருக்காது. அவங்க என்னவோ சொல்லிட்டு இருப்பாங்க, இர்ரெலவெண்டாக நிறைய மெசேஜ் பேசுவாங்க. தேர் ஆர் லாட் ஆஃப் அன்வான்ட் மெசேஜஸ் வி ஆர் ப்ரொனவுன்சிங் எவ்ரி டே. வி நீட் டு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட். அதை வந்து நம்ம எடுத்து சொல்லணும் பப்ளிக்ன்றது. இந்த அந்த நோக்கத்துக்கு தான் இந்த ஒரு ப்ரோக்ராம் இன்னைக்கு. ஆஸ் அ பார்ட் ஆஃப் த ப்ரோக்ராம், எஸ்டர்டே பவானி ராமலிங்கம் பேசினாங்க. அவங்க ஸ்டார்டிங்லேருந்து கம்யூனிகேஷன் பற்றி கொஞ்சம் சொல்லிட்டு ரெண்டு மூணு சினாரியோ அற்புதமாக சொன்னாங்க. 10 பாயிண்ட் பிளான், அற்புதமான பாயிண்ட் சொன்னாங்க. ஸோ இன் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் டைமென்ஷன், அதை தவிர வேறு ஒரு டைமென்ஷனில் ஐ ஆம் எக்ஸ்பெக்டிங் ஃப்ரம் தர்ஷனா டுடே. ஸோ தர்ஷனா இஸ் கோயிங் டு டேக் த செஷன். வி லவ் த செஷன். ஐ ஆம் ஹேண்டிங் ஓவர் த செஷன் டு தர்ஷனா.
தேங்க்யூ சார்.
Yeah.
Sir, a small request. Can you please record the video, sir? Because I am
yeah,
not
yeah,
able to do it.
Yeah. I'll record it. Is it on the Google
over?
Yes. The page la na tag panna kuda ungala web page la unga Facebook page la share pannirken. Paருங்க, tag pannirken.
Yes, sir.
Now we can proceed.
A very good evening to one and all. It gives me immense pleasure to be back here because I was a part of this program when it started. So I really enjoyed it and I wanted to be a part of it even more because this is something I used to do back then when I was in my college. But now since I started working, I think this is giving me an additional opportunity to explore new arenas of life. So this is based on reality of communication. One thing I always feel is, be it any situation, the key is communication. If we don't forget this, we can win over any situation and anything. Because right now, what we see is a lot of communication problems, a lot of miscommunications, a lot of communication gap. But there are reasons why it is happening. Nothing happens without a reason, right? So everybody's life will have different reasons, different scenarios. I would explain the scenarios that I went through or my closed ones or friends went through. Whenever we talk, what's more important? We don't understand that more than the content or the content, the importance should be given to the target audience. Without knowing the target audience, we keep speaking and it reaches nowhere. Even we actually you waste our energy on something because they do not understand. Now, for example, if I know French and if I speak in French, if audience doesn't understand French, how does it make sense? It doesn't make sense at all, right? Even though my points will be really good, it doesn't make sense at all because it wouldn't reach the audience. In the same scenario, people think that if you know English, you can shine or, you know, you can get success. But I think English is just a language and a medium of communication, not communication itself. We need to understand and differentiate the fact that it is a medium. What we need to make sure is what we are speaking, the other person should understand. And what other person is speaking, we need to understand. For that, we need to be a good speaker as well as a good listener. Otherwise, it wouldn't work. If I keep speaking and speaking, how will it work? Now, in between, I need to ask if my audience is understanding, if my audience is reciprocating, or if I have to be interactive enough. If I'm not being interactive, then what's the point? I will keep speaking. And sir, are you able to understand? Ma'am, do you understand? I need to check in between at least once, right? Or else I need to see their facial expressions to understand, are they getting my point? Some people would be acting too smart, just saying, nodding their head. Yes, in the classroom, I have seen this. My friends would be doing, but they would be sleeping inside only. They wouldn't be listening to the teacher. And the faculty will keep speaking, okay? She is spending her energy on the students, but students wouldn't listen because in statistics, it is proof that a student can listen to a maximum of 20 minutes at a stretch. So in a class of 60 minutes, if for 20 minutes a teacher takes, definitely the student will listen. But a teacher is also like, no, I have to complete the syllabus. 60 minutes I need to take. Even if the student is not listening, the teacher will take the class. Rather, what they can do is 20 minutes they can take class, 10 minutes of break in between, again 20 minutes of class. 40 productive minutes you get. Otherwise, just 20 productive minutes. Now, the choice is on us. How do we choose, right? And one more thing which I feel is I have seen a lot of people, when they communicate, they just communicate without any emotions. I think if I keep reading, communication problem, whenever we talk, what's more important? Do you guys understand? Is it even like, do you want to listen to it? No, nobody would want to listen to this, right? Because it is so boring. If there is an important point and we need to explain it, we need to be expressive. Unless we are expressive, it becomes very difficult because there are a lot of introverts, extroverts. I wouldn't say that introverts are wrong or extroverts are right. No, it is the way how we perceive things, how we make the other person understand. For example, you can ask me, why do you say introverts, they cannot express? But I have a very good example. Like, I have seen my mimes during my annual day programs. People, they will not speak, but the way they project the creativity, a wonderful moral will be revealed just by miming. So I will never accept that introverts cannot be expressive or only extroverts are expressive, right? To communicate, we need to be expressive. And to listen, we need to be expressive again. If someone is speaking for us, we need to be expressive enough to show the emotions that, yes, we are getting. No, I am having some doubt. So by seeing the facial expression, the communicator would understand, yes, my audience is getting, my audience is not getting. But what a lot of people do, you know, they'll be having mobile phones and chatting, okay. And when we ask question, they will not have any answer because they do not, what they do is they just pretend that they are listening, but they don't listen, right? And they lose out on a lot of important points just because of this. And a lot of people think that, you know, body language, confidence, all plays a vital role in communication. We would have seen after COVID, a lot of schools, a lot of companies have started having virtual interviews, not a lot, but majority of the companies. Now, why do they have video calls? Because they will understand the confidence level, the body language of a candidate. If they do not understand, they cannot come to a conclusion that how will he reciprocate or how will he or she react to the situation. That's why we always have video calls. Earlier, even in the classroom, when I was studying, we never had online classes. All my teachers used to be like, did you understand? Do you understand? This is how they will check, or they will read from our facial expression. Now in online classes, what kids do? They will start the online class. They will go from here, turn off the video. And the teacher will be speaking and speaking, which is of no use. She prepares so hard. He or she, the faculty, prepares really hard for the students, but they take it so lethargically and do not pay attention to them. Now, this is a major drawback wherein parents can help the students and the kids coordinate. Because I don't know for how long the COVID will go, but the online teaching will go on because we have a lot of edutech platforms now. So we need to understand, yes, we have to be interactive. We have to, you know, make our kids sit and listen. Now it's a faculty's job how to make the class interactive. Any student wouldn't just be sitting in the class. Now, if I keep reading, you will also not listen. What is she even talking? I will turn off the video and go because this is boring. Nobody would want to listen to boring lectures, right? If I don't like to listen, why will I expect others to listen to my boring lecture? It's as simple as that. When I was a kid, I liked cartoons and I liked everything to be projected in the form of cartoons. But now I do not like it that way. So you need to understand the age difference as well. You need to communicate as per the age as well. Now, something is really important. Some aspect is really important and we have to communicate to others. Now, we need to understand what is the age group? How will I explain? How should I explain? That is more important than just going and explaining. For example, my family, not everybody will be very much open to a lot of things. But it is up to me how I go and reach out to them. If I go and say, Mom, I want this. This is what I want. I am doing this. My mom would say, you shut up and sit at home. Do not do anything. So if I go and say this to my friends, they would understand because the age difference is there. So we need to talk in a way that they can also get our words. Because what we speak is important. If we think it's important, we need to make it in a way that it feels important to others as well. So a lot of times I have seen misunderstandings arise in relationships these days. Because in one room, two people will be not talking, they will just be shouting without listening to each other. And what happens? They will never arrive at a solution. But the problem will entangle and they will come to a conclusion that they are breaking apart or they are getting a divorce. Why a lot of cases are happening now and not in the older generation? Even research says this, people don't listen to understand, people listen to argue. If arguing is my goal, I can never understand the other person. If two people in the same room are angry at the same time, it is very difficult. It is like fire is meeting with fire. How will it work? At least if fire is there, one should be water, right? If one is arguing, the other should at least listen and understand, then react to it. A lot of problems happen because of this. I have myself seen with a lot of friends, even when I call my friend, if I have an important thing to say, my friend will be starting his or her story. Now, you need to understand that I am in a difficult situation. That's why I have called you. Okay, if you are also in a difficult situation, that I need to understand and not disturb you, and call someone who will be able to understand. Because everybody is going through some or the other thing in their life. We cannot blame anybody that, you know, he is not listening to me, she is not listening to me. We need to know, okay, this is the time we can go. Not every time we can go and vent out everything, no. They are also human beings. They also have a lot of things going on. So all the time, we cannot go and dump others. But what is important, we should come to the point first. Then we can explain what is not important. Because we cook up so many stories that the important part is actually missed. What's the point of cooking the entire story, right? It's just like we are preparing a meal, a healthy meal, but we are overcooking it. The healthiness, the crunchiness of the food actually fades away, right? There is no point of eating such healthy meal then. So we can compare this to the food we eat in our day-to-day life. And sometimes I used to be an anchor in my school and college days. Okay. So I came across this many a times that I had to anchor for a science event. I had to anchor for a kids event. The anchoring should be different for both. I cannot have the same style or the same tone when I'm anchoring. Otherwise, the kids will not like it, you know. If I demonstrate with a lot of cartoons, the kids will definitely enjoy it. And they will be enthusiastic to perform. And if it is a serious event, I cannot be in a playful tone, right? Now, for example, someone is calling and saying, my mom's health isn't well. I am not well. You cannot laugh at that. I'm like, okay, you cannot take it lethargically. So the tone of your voice matters a lot. So many a times we have come across that texting always creates more problem than having a call over the phone. In text, we do not understand because there is no emotion involved. What we do, we just text. Even if they're angry, we will not understand. Now we have emojis, but how much emojis can explain? A real person, now we are having a video call. So I can see, okay, is Shivani listening to me? Is Sir listening to me? Are they not listening? I can change my tone to make them listen to me, right? Now that depends on the orator, how they do it. So that's why I always prefer calling or having a video chat over a text. Yes, it is true that you can tell me, you know, when we mail somebody, it acts as a proof. Yes, the important details should be as a proof, but the explanation should be given on a call. So we understand, the other person will also be able to understand. Otherwise, there is no point of me speaking so much or him listening so much to me. This is two-way communication. Sometimes we have to listen to certain things and certain people without reacting. Not every time we can react. When we react, what happens? When we know the conclusion, we can react. When we do not know the conclusion, we cannot react to it. For example, I like reading, I like watching YouTube, motivational YouTube videos. Now, I don't want others' opinion in between, right? Because I follow that person. I want to listen completely to that person. Only then I will be able to help myself. Okay, this is my motivational speaker. I am understanding. I am doing. In between, if my friend is coming, no, what are you doing? This is really boring. No, this is not boring to me. I feel his words are astonishing me. I would definitely listen. And at that time, you need to make sure that only you are listening to them without any disturbance. Because when there are a lot of people involved, there is only going to be a chaos happening and nothing else. Right? So now I can talk about this in a business perspective. I was a part of digital marketing team after my bachelor's. So communication played a vital role in marketing communication. when I talk about marketing communication, you would ask me, how does it play? But it actually does. When we see Facebook, when we see Instagram, we see a lot of advertisements popping up, don't we? We do see, right? So what happens is, the age group beyond 35 use Facebook more than Instagram. So now if I have an advertisement relating to a person aged above 35, I would market on Facebook and not waste my money on Instagram. So that's where communication again plays a vital role, that we need to know the target audience. Yes, I can market here. Now, if you go to villages, not everybody use Facebook or Instagram, or they're not very much active. The old people may not be very active. So to reach out to them, we need to advertise in the television. We need to understand how we can reach out to them. Only when we understand the question how, we will be able to fulfill what we want to fulfill. Otherwise, it becomes just a waste of time, isn't it? So that plays a very vital role. Now, you may ask, I was speaking so much. How do I reciprocate when somebody speaks to me? That is more important, because telling a lot of things is very easy. But when it comes to self, it is very difficult. Now, certain things I was sharing out of my own experience, because I had this habit of listening to half and reacting, which is not right at all, because half truth is never better than a lie, or lie is better than half truth, as we all say, right? So I never used to listen and I'll be like, I know this, but the conclusion is something else. Now, when I feel that way, I listen to other person first, tend to understand, okay, he would have gone through some situation. That's why he has reacted. Because a lot of people I've seen, they are very angry. They get angry very easily. They speak certain things which they don't mean. Because of the anger they speak, because they do not realize what they are speaking. Because all they want is, I am angry. How can she or he tell me this? I have to speak. That's what they do. And that's where a lot of problems arises. Because we shouldn't be doing it. We need to give us some time, take at least 5 to 10 minutes and analyze why someone has told me this, then react. Yes, if this is some illegal or some non-violence is happening, I will never ask you to wait and react, because at that time, immediate action is important. So you need to understand the difference between when immediate action is required, when it is not required. It will come only with experience. It cannot come overnight. Like today I'm saying, do not get angry. No, you cannot. Day by day, slowly you will be able to inculcate that habit, right? If you do not inculcate, then it's a loss. But if you're trying, then I think it's better, right? Because slow progress is also progress. At least you're trying. That's more important. Now, I have had a person who will just call me and say about all his stories. Will bitch about different people. Why do you have to talk about so many people? Why do you have to talk bad behind others? If I am not interested, I should say on the face that please do not do this to me, because I have already a lot of things to think about. Why do I need to know about other stories? Now, a lot of people will be struggling, like, what should I do? He or she is my friend. I have to listen. But you're actually giving the wrong thing, you're accepting a wrong thing, right? If you know that this is wrong, be brave enough and courageous enough to say, my dear friend, this is what you're doing is not right, because it is none of my business. Why do I need to listen to it? If you keep listening to it, the story will keep increasing, and which is of no use. Instead of having unnecessary talks, we can have some productive discussions, right? Time is so precious. What's the point in having unnecessary discussions? Now, two friends are talking. A group of four friends are talking. Hanging out is okay. Going out, chilling is all fun. Everybody enjoys it. I enjoy it. But sometime at the end of the day, if we do not have a productive conversation, are they even my productive friends? Am I having a healthy bond with people? No. Are they helping me to uplift myself, or are they putting me down? Because your relatives and your family, your friends, who are jealous of you will always put you down. They will taunt you. You will feel, I think I'm doing something wrong. I am not confident enough. You will have that inside you. Do not let that happen with you. Because you are the person who have come to this place, who have taken a stand for yourself. Please continue doing it. Do not let others, you know, let your confidence down. Please do not do that, because that's the most difficult thing, to come out of it again, right? So what I always feel is, if I'm on the stage and if someone is commenting on me, you know, people have stage fear because some other person will comment on me. I always think, at least I am on the stage. He is standing there and commenting. Am I not at a better place? Am I not better than what I did yesterday? If I feel I am better, then I am doing good for myself and for the society I am living in. So to be any situation, anything we are into, any problem, communication is the only solution. The right communication is the only solution, be it your school, be it your college, be it your corporate. Yes, one example I forgot to quote. I was in a meeting, okay? And I had two meetings. I will give you an example of two meetings. What happened in the first meeting, we were like six people and he was a boss. He was not a leader. A manager should be like a leader, not like a boss. When he is like a boss, he will never listen to others. He will keep saying what he wants to say and he will just go, team, do this work. How will the team understand if you do not make the team understand? Ultimately, the loss is for the owner and the founder, not for the boss, right? Just because he is the boss, he cannot rule anybody, right? So productivity in that month was really less because we were not able to understand to what our boss was saying. And if we ask him questions, one more thing, you need to ask questions. If you do not ask, when you don't understand, what is the point of listening? If you have questions, raise it. If you don't have, then it's fine. Now, when I raised a question, he was not answering. He was like, no, this is what I am saying. This is right. If every day you keep saying, I will also lose interest. Okay, yeah, it's okay. This is my work. I will complete and go. I will not have interest. When you don't have interest, you will not be able to work with that enthusiasm, right? And other scenario, our boss, I wouldn't even say he's a boss. He was just like our colleague or a friend. He used to ask us the opinions, how we do this, how do we take it? And he was projecting everything in a PowerPoint so that the audience understand in a better way with the help of slides and everything. So if I keep speaking, they will get bored of looking at my face. No, is my face so interesting that they'll keep looking at me for like 1 or 2 hours? No, nobody would do. Everybody needs a minimum entertainment in between, right? So with this, I don't want to bore you all much. With this, I am signing off. This is Darshana Lalit Kumar for the day. And any questions, you're please welcome to ask me anything. Thank you.
Thank you, Darshana. Thank you very much. So
thank you, sir.
Wonderful, wonderful. It is a wonderful talk. I didn't expect this. Really happy. So you give a nice time. There is a lot of things to explain, even the business, even in office. These are the things that are very much important, actually. See, the boss or the leader, team leader, they should understand what they are doing. And then they should have a good relationship with the team. So that is important. So once they understand the things, only then they can able to understand the people. Then they will have good relationship. Once they created the relationship, the teamwork will be a pura productive. Otherwise, you will not get enthusiastic. You will not get involved in your work. See, this is what we need. So, from office side means corporate side, there are a lot of things that are happening. If you want to talk about those things, means we need to have another one hour.
Another session.
So it needs, then we'll plan for some other session also. Anyhow, very good session. I'm really happy.
Thank you, sir.
Shivani, do you want to talk something?
I'm really happy seeing my friend like this, actually.
Great, great.
Actually, she gave the link to me just 5-10 minutes back.
Mm.
I just felt I should join the session and know how my friend has grown this much. And I'm really happy seeing her like this.
Thank you so much, Shivani, for joining at a very short notice. Because I knew if I text you, you will definitely join. That's why I texted only few who will definitely join.
So, I'm really happy that you called me that you can join the session. It made me really happy listening to you. And I just remembered what and all I did as mistake and what and all I need to change.
Right.
It was really nice, actually. You covered everything which I need to know. So it was good listening it.
Very good, very good. So this is what the program, actually, this program. See, we don't understand what we are doing. Most of the time, no, we don't understand what is are we talking really good way, or people are liking me or not. We don't understand. If somebody says these are the things you need to change, means there we need to understand. This program will make people to understand. This is the core theme of the program. Anyhow, thanks for good lecture. Thanks for Shivani joining here. And Bhavani is here. Bhavani, do you want to talk something? Yesterday, she gave a lecture.
Okay.
Bhavani, are you here? Are you hearing?
I think she has muted herself. So that's why she's... Yeah.
No, she didn't. Yeah. Bhavani, unmute your... Are you there? Bhavani, are you hearing? கேக்குதா? இருக்கீங்களா? நீ அன்மியூட் பண்ணிட்டு பேசுங்க.
Everywhere this unmute issue is happening. unmute yourself.
Anyhow, Bhavani is taking time. I don't know. We'll have a talk with her. Wait, let me finish the Facebook live. Okay.
So, any questions?
Any question from me? Yeah. There are no questions.
I'm really happy listening. I was happy for everything. Whatever you told, I was happy that whatever I wanted, it was there.
I'm glad I could cover. So I think it would help a lot of people, you know, with different scenarios and examples. Sure. Yeah.
So thanks.
Try some more sessions. Sure. Try some more topics.
Sure. There are a lot of Facebook friends. I think they watched for everyone. I thank personally. Everyone should come and join with us to move with good thoughts to the society. We will create a good society in future. That is the aim of this program, Mind Your Mind. Whether we are really minding our mind or not, that is the aim of this program. We have to go inside, think. And what we are thinking, we need to think. See, this is the aim. See, we need to think and we need to go inside and we need to think what we are thinking. Do you follow? It may be a little confusing, but that's what we need to do. We are generating thoughts. We are generating many ideas. We have many thoughts and it is coming out. Before it is coming out, again, go inside. Whether we have generated good thoughts or not, what we are going to deliver, what we are thinking, what mind is telling, everything, we need to think again and process. There is a second process of thinking we need. So this is what I said, mind your mind, okay, with me. Anyhow, happy joining. Please wait, let me finish. Let me close.